Good morning. We have Sean H. Robertson of Michigan Film Industry here. He is not only a published author, he's a writer, an actor, and a screenplay writer. He just finished writing a book, The Cries of Vampira. Welcome, Sean.
Thank you very much, Val. Appreciate it.
So, what actually inspired you to start writing?
Well, I've been writing since I was a kid, about 10 years old, and I used to write short stories in the fifth grade, and I was an extreme nerd, so I used to write stories about me saving some of the girls in the classroom so I could get cool with them, and it kind of took on its own life and everything, and I started writing songs and poetry and things like that, and just recently started writing books and short and screenplays in the last couple years.
I see that you have wrote the book, The Cries of Vampira. Mm-hmm. So are you planning on making a movie from the book?
Well, the book has been out for about a couple years now. It's gotten a lot of international accolades and great reviews. And right now I have a film company that I can't name out of Hollywood that's actually previewing it. And they'll be letting me know like in the next 60 to 90 days if they're interested in turning it into a screenplay. So I'm really excited about that, and hopefully we can shoot some of it here and bring some jobs to Michigan.
Oh, that would be wonderful. So where can people get The Cries of Vampira?
The Cries of Vampira is online now at Amazon.com. It's on Barnes & Noble as well, and you can buy the physical copy as well as the electronic ebook copies on Kindle and in the Barnes & Noble Nook.
Wonderful.
For like 99 cents. Yeah, so it's really affordable.
So your life as an actor, what was your prize role, Mr. Robertson?
I would say thus far, Detroit 187 is a fantastic series that we had here. Of course, it just got canceled, but it was really good for Michigan, really good for the local actors here. It gave us an opportunity to showcase our skills and our talents to the overall film industry. And I was cast as a guest co-star police officer in episode 6, and I was able to work in a scene with Michael Imperioli and John Michael Hill, and actually got a chance to meet those guys and talk to those guys off camera, and they were phenomenal, and they really inspired me to aim even higher because they're the top-notch performers.
Absolutely, what a treasured experience.
Oh.
So you have a film company that's 313 Wood, correct?
Yes.
Okay, would you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, 313 Wood is basically my idea of bringing the synergy of Michigan talent together. And basically doing our own version of our films, of our creativity, of our imagination as far as, to the entertainment world. And basically just trying to get everyone to realize that, if we inspire ourselves and if we work together and build relationships here together, that we can build our own version of Hollywood here. And we don't have to be dependent on others to come here and film here.
So leading into that, the Great Lakes State, would you like to share with the people exactly what that is and where you're going with that?
Sure. Great Lakes State, I was inspired to do that after Detroit 187 was canceled. A lot of us, were really, upset by that and hurt by that, because it brought, I believe last count, they spent over $38 million here locally. And it provided a lot of jobs internally, and the money didn't go to state coffers. It actually went to people who are Michigan citizens who actually needed the jobs, the hotels, the actors, the crews, the cleaners, all of these people that were dependent on it. And so when we lost it, I was kind of inspired to, try to at least maybe create our own new TV show. Great Lakes State is basically going to be about a politician, a woman who basically is a governor, and she takes over the state after the state has basically gone through a lot of turmoil and loss of jobs and kind of devastation, and she's basically stepping in as this incorruptible woman who wants to bring about a better life in Michigan's rebirth. And so we're really excited about it, and I cast Real Scafone as the lead in it, who's one of Michigan's most experienced actors here. We're absolutely thrilled that we're going to be raising funds to create this project to where it's going to have paid jobs and SAG accreditation for the local Michigan talent here.
So tell us a little about the Michigan Made Film Summer Party, please.
The Michigan Made Film Summer Party is a party that we just launched to the public a couple days ago. Basically, we came up with this idea of the Michigan Made Film Party. People can come out and build new relationships. And the key in this industry is relationships. And learn that, there's some people out here that you need to know that can help you You know, but if you don't make that effort to get out and actually meet these people and become, you know, friends with them and build, you know, bonds and chemistry with them, then, you know, you have no one to blame but yourself, you know, if you're not where you want to be as far as fulfilling your goals and dreams in the film industry here in Michigan. So really excited about it. We launched it a couple of days ago and we already got 100 people committing that they're coming out.
Oh, that's
wonderful.
And
so we're really excited about that.
That is absolutely wonderful. So what are you going to do to raise money? Is there a cover?
Yeah, there's a cover of about $10 at the door, but that includes free food, and we're working on getting some other free things as far as chips and cupcakes and things like that. We got bar specials and everything. We got karaoke as entertainment, and then we're working on some other surprises as well. So about $10 is basically wrapped up in actually supporting the event, because of course, you know, these events can't be free.
Are you instilling these values in your daughter too, to follow her dreams, be artistic, or?
Absolutely, yeah. I have she'll be 15 in August. Her name is Kristen, and I tell her the same thing. I mean, you have to dream big, you know, in this world, you really do. But at the same time, you have to be committed to doing whatever you need to do to make that dream happen.
Right.
And there's going to be some sacrifices. There's going to be some, you know, some ebbs and flows. There's going to be some roller coaster rides or whatever, but you have to be committed to the end goal, and whatever that dream is, you just have to solve for it. And so that's basically what I'm doing, and she's being encouraged by that. When she saw me on Detroit 187 as a cop, I think she finally got it, that, you know, okay, dad's really serious here.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Actually working out.
So is she into acting as well?
It's funny that you asked that.
She's acting.
She originally wanted to be a fashion designer and have her own fashion line, which I think she's still probably going to do. But again, after the last year or so of seeing a lot of acting, she said, hey, you know what? I think I want to get into theater. And I'm encouraging her to do whatever, again, whatever she wants to do. I just think the key is we have to tell our youth, you know, that we support you 1,000%. You know, and I think, again, with the same thing with the film incentives, everyone, you know, was telling everyone to get educated here and trying to keep our youth here so we don't have a brain drain and kids running to other states for jobs. And then the rug is pulled, and then our kids are wondering, hey, what's going on? I thought you said that you had my back.
Well, I'm sure your daughter is exactly like you. Apple does not fall far from the tree.
Try.
So she will be multi-talented, fashion and or acting, or probably even possibly writing. Is that what I read too?
Yeah, actually she's a writer as well.
She's a writer?
Yeah.
Right, like your daddy.
She's working on her new book too?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure she's, Kristen is she's apple of my eye, and she's going to do some really, really great things. And, you know, again, the sky's the limit. The sky's the limit. So I just tell her that. You just cannot think of the limitations, you know, because as soon as you put a limitation in front of yourself, then you box yourself in. So when I tell people that, a lot of people kind of sometimes, I won't say a lot of people, but some people may take it as like arrogance, because I think I can kind of do anything, but I think I can do anything.
Well, that's because you can do anything.
And we can't, and all of us can do anything.
Right.
If we stay focused and stay passionate about what we want to do. Hollywood was built in California 100 years ago, and they did it. They had a dream. And so we need to have that same dream here from Michigan and build it ourselves here, and we can do it.
Sean, you are amazing, and I cannot thank you enough. We cannot thank you enough for you coming by today, taking time out of your day. I know that you want to go see yourself on the big screen.
I can support some friends.
Absolutely, absolutely. So where can people get a hold of you, in contact with you? I know the book is on Amazon, Twitter and Facebook, I'm sure, correct?
Yep, Twitter and Facebook, Sean H. Robertson, S-E-A-N H. Robertson. Twitter and Facebook is the biggest way to get a hold of me, and I'm open to talk to anyone in the film industry and encourage, you know, anyone that I can encourage and help us on, you know, get to the next level.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for joining us today. We've been honored and blessed to have Sean H. Robertson with us.
Thank you, Modern Tribe. Appreciate it, guys. Thank you. And much success to your new show.